studying about parts firstly. Okay, without seeing your book, you have already studied these chapters in your previous classes. Tell me how many parts of speech are there?
Sir, eight.
Very good. Name them.
Sir, noun, pronoun,
verb, adverb, adjective, preposition, conjunction.
Morning, sir.
Interjections and conjunctions.
Very good, very good. So there are total eight parts of speech: noun, pronoun, adjective, adverb, verb, prepositions, conjunctions, and interjections. Right?
Interjections.
How many parts of speech there in total? Eight.
Sir, eight.
Eight, right?
Good morning, sir.
Good morning. Good morning. Okay. So today.
What you are teaching?
Parts of speech, chapter number 3. Okay? Chapter number 3.
Chapter number 3. Yes, sir.
Okay. Now. So, in this chapter, this parts of speech is very important. And in this chapter, we'll be dealing in detail with all the parts of speech. Okay?
Okay, sir.
So, whenever you speak any language, so in English, these eight parts of speech is very important. In this sentence, parts of speech means speech. What does speech mean? Speech means daily conversation. What you converse, what you talk to each other. That is your speech. Okay? And these eight parts of speech you use in your daily life. Every time when you are talking, right? I'm saying now, whatever I'm saying to you, I am saying these eight parts of speech only. So these eight parts of speech is the most important part of your speaking, of your speech. Okay? So you must be very familiar. You must have to understand. You must have a very good command on all the eight parts of speech. Okay?
Okay, yes, sir.
Sharing my screen and we'll be studying the eight parts of speech in detail. Now, here is a cartoon you can see on the screen where all the eight parts of speech are given in total.
Yes, sir.
Now,
yes, sir.
So now let us see the eight parts of speech. I have already explained you what is speech. Speech is a conversation. Okay, and the parts of speech, the eight things which are required, which are present in our speech, are these things. And what are those eight parts of speech? Noun, pronoun.
Noun, pronoun.
Noun,
pronoun. Adjective, verb, adverb, conjunctions.
Eight parts of speech. Okay, and we'll be learning all those eight parts of speech in detail. Okay, children.
Yes, sir.
The definition of noun. We have already studied every time. Most of the time we have studied. This yes, what is a noun? Noun is the name of person,
place,
thing or idea.
It is the name of person, place.
Word is called noun. Everything in the world has its name. Like you are Kavya, you are Ananya, you are Shiv Shankar, right? Everyone has its own name. If I call Shiv Shankar, so Shiv Shankar will only answer to me, right? If I call Kavya, so Kavya will only answer to me, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And everything, yes, sir. Nouns, if I say table, so table means a particular thing on which you write, right? Chair.
Yes.
Chair means a thing on yes, where you sir. Sit, on which you sit, right? If I say mobile phone, you know what is mobile phone, right? If I say pen, pencil, it is used for writing. So all yes, these things are having its own name. Pen, pencil, fan, table, chair, duster, flower, cow, ox, Taj Mahal, Gorakhpur. These all are names of different things, right? These all are naming yes, words. And we use these words in our daily life, in our daily routine, in our daily conversation, right? So this is also a part of speech. Noun is the first and the most important part of speech. Understood?
Speech.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, see the examples. Examples are cat, fireman, house, pencil, and Chicago. Chicago is the name of a city, okay?
Yes, sir.
Moving to the next part of speech, that is the pronoun.
Pronoun.
How you can understand pronoun? You know?
Pronoun is a word that plays of noun.
Used to place of
noun. Of noun
used word used in place.
Because you might have been very familiar with pro word. Apple, there's no iPhone 12 and iPhone 12 Pro. Both are having a difference now. iPhone 12 means the normal phone and iPhone 12 Pro is the upgraded version of iPhone 12. Right?
Yes, sir.
Let's give you an example. So what is pronoun? pronoun is the upgraded version of noun.
Used to place of a noun.
Okay, pronoun is the upgraded version of noun. It is, pronoun is a word which is used in place of noun. If I continuously say that Anubhav is a student of class 5, Anubhav comes to school daily, Anubhav goes to home daily, Anubhav completes his homework. If I'm using Anubhav, Anubhav every time, so is this making a good sense? No,
using no. Using Anubhav. Sir. No, sir. Sir, he.
Yes. So sir, using, Anubhav is a student of class 5. He comes to school daily. He goes to home daily. So in place of Anubhav, I am using his. I am using he. I am using him. Right?
Yes.
Sir. Anubhav is a noun. Is the it is a name of a person. Right? Anubhav is what? Anubhav is a noun. So I'm using he, him and his in place of Anubhav, right? So this will be the pronoun. So these are the words which are being used in place of nouns, and these are called as pronouns. Good. So what are pronouns? Pronouns are the words which are used in place of nouns. Is it clear? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, Shivshankar, is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Understanding? Now see the examples here. She, it, they, you, we, these all are pronouns. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Kavya, Anubhav, Ananya, Shivshankar are studying English. In place of telling your name, I can say one word, that is they are studying, right?
Yes, sir.
Use they in place of calling everybody's name. I can use they, right? So they is the pronoun. Is it clear?
Yes.
Any problem?
That they are playing.
They are playing.
Yes, sir.
They are studying. They are talking. We are studying.
That they are playing.
Sir, she is doing her work.
She's doing her work. So she and her are the pronouns, right?
Yes, sir.
And
yes, sir.
He, his, him is used for male. She, her, and hers is used for female, and it is used for animals mostly. Okay? Understood?
Yes, sir.
Now we'll be learning adjective. Two parts of speech are done. The third part of speech will be adjective. Okay?
Yes,
what
sir.
Is adjective? An adjective is a word
which
describes a pronoun. It can describe or modify a noun also, or it can describe or modify a pronoun also. What is describe and what is modify? If I say, see, my phone is black in color. If I say, my mobile phone is black in color. So what is mobile phone?
It's a noun.
And the sentence is telling about the color of my mobile phone, right?
Yes, sir.
So
yes,
the sir. Color is black. It is describing the mobile phone, and mobile phone is a noun. So in the word black is describing the color. It is describing the noun, that is mobile phone. So black will be adjective. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Clear now? Now see.
Yes, sir.
Let me write one example here. See. The example is, I have a black pen. Black pen.
Pen.
Okay. I have a black pen. See, here, I is what? Noun or pronoun?
Sir. Pronoun. Sir, pronoun.
Sir, pronoun.
And the word black is describing the color of the this and pen is a noun?
Yes, sir.
This the word black is describing the color of the pen, right or wrong?
Yes, sir.
Black will be what?
Sir, adjective.
Understood?
Yes, sir.
Let us see one more example. He is a good boy.
He is a good boy.
Now, which is adjective here?
Sir, good.
Is adjective and boy is noun.
Boy is noun and sir.
Is the word good?
Sir, he is pronoun.
Noun and boy is noun here. Understood now?
Yes, sir.
Shiv Shankar?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Any problem?
No, sir.
Now, no, sir. See, happy, sad, red, short, tall, fat, hairy, these all are the examples of adjective. Anything that describes or modifies a noun or pronoun will be called as adjective.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Any problem?
No, sir.
I'm not going fast, na? Is it sure, na? Have you all understood?
Yes, sir.
But this is a very easy chapter, and you have already learnt in your previous classes, right?
Yes, sir.
See, part of speech is very important.
Most people
don't know parts of speech. Okay, so you have to be very clear with the concept. Okay.
Yes, sir.
That, because on these 8 parts of speech, you have all the chapters after this. After this, you will study noun, after this, you will study pronoun. So first, understanding the basic things in short, in this chapter is very important. And parts of speech is a very important part of this. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
You'll be studying about verb. Okay? Yeah. Very easy. I have all the time told to you what is verb, what
yes,
it
sir. Does, what it yes, does. Sir.
It is very easy, very easy. Whatever work you perform, you are studying right now, right?
Yes, sir.
You are doing any work? Study. If I say clap, I'm doing any work that I'm clapping?
Yes, sir.
It's also work I'm performing. If you are sleeping, though physically you are not doing any work, but in English language, you are performing a work that is sleeping. Sleeping is a task you perform. It's the action that you are doing. Right?
Yes, sir.
Whatever action that you do, eat, sleep, dance, cook, okay, sing, these all will be verbs.
Yes, sir.
And it tells you, so what are verbs? Words are that words which tells you what someone or something is doing. Okay? What?
Yes, sir.
It tells you the action of a person.
Sir.
It tells you action of a noun or a pronoun. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Like if I say, I am teaching. So what work I am doing?
Teaching.
Teaching.
So teaching will be what? It will be a verb.
Yes, okay. Sir.
You are studying. So what work you are doing? What action you are performing?
Study.
Studying.
Study.
Studying is a work that you are performing. It is the action that you are doing. So studying will be the verb. Understood?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Any problem?
No, sir.
Ask an example. Sit. Laugh, run, jump. These all are the examples of verb. Okay?
Laugh,
yes, sir. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Sir, they are laughing.
They are laughing. So what is laughing?
Sir, verb.
It's an action. It is also a verb that is being performed. Shiv Shankar, is it clear?
Sir, is running.
Running. Running is also a verb. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Understood, no?
Yes, sir.
He is running, he is sitting.
He's running, he is dancing, he is singing, anything it can be.
Yes, he's
thinking, drinking. Okay?
She is sitting.
Yes, he's sitting. Yes, sitting is also a verb. Very good. Now, next is adverb. Okay, with the name you can easily suggest. Adverb, it means that which adds something to the verb is called adverb. Understanding? This is the?
Yes, sir.
This is the fifth type of part of speech. This is called as adverb. Adverb means which adds something to the verb will be called as adverb. So the words which add something to the verb will be called as adverb. In short, if you don't want to cramp the definition, just break the word. Okay? Adverb. It means that which adds something to the verb is called as adverb. Now, let us see the definition of the case. The words that can be added to a verb, see, it has came now?
Yes, sir.
The word which can be added to the verb, okay? To modify its meaning. What? To modify its meaning. It can also modify adjectives and other adverbs. Means that, what does adverbs do? Adverbs are the words which are added to the verbs.
Yes, sir.
Adverbs are the words which are added to the verbs to modify the word. The word can be a verb, it can be a noun, it can be a pronoun or anything. These will be called as, or it can be adjective also. These will be called as
adverbs. Yes, sir.
Am I clear? Now see. And what yes, it sir. Tells you, it tells you when, where, how, and in what manner or to what extent an action is performed. It tells you that where the action, where the work is done. Okay, if I say he is running on the ground. If I say he is running slowly. Okay, if I'm saying slowly, slowly is telling you now in what manner the work is being performed. Right?
Yes, sir.
It is telling you now that kaise wo daud raha hai, he is running slowly. So slowly is what? Slowly is the
adverb.
And how he is running? He is running slowly. Right? So slowly is what? Slowly will be the adverb. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Any problem?
No, sir.
Shiv Shankar.
Yes, sir.
Problem?
No, sir.
Okay, now, sir. Let us write one simple sentence. God is everywhere. God is everywhere. Okay. Now see here. In this sentence. Example is now God is everywhere. So is this yes, also a verb? Is this an auxiliary verb or helping verb? Right?
Yes. Sir.
Is this a helping verb? And where is God? God is everywhere. It is showing that the where God is. It is showing you the location of God. So God is present everywhere. So what is everywhere? Everywhere will be the and.
Adverb.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Anubhav.
Yes, sir.
Is it clear?
Yes, sir. It's clear.
Clear or it is clear to you?
Sir, it is clear.
Okay. Understood, children? Na?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
The child is coming here. Now this is a sentence. The child is coming here. Tell me where is the adverb?
They're coming.
They're coming.
Coming is adverb?
Yes, sir.
Coming. No?
Yes, sir.
Coming is verb. Coming is the work that is being performed. Coming is verb.
Sir, child. Sir, child.
Child? No.
Sir, here.
Child is noun, na?
Sir, here.
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 Here is the adverb. You are confused again. Child is what? Child is noun, right?
Sir.
It is the name of a class. Child. Right?
Yes.
And what is coming? Yes, is also a verb. Helping verb. Is it what? Is helping verb.
Helping and verb.
Coming is the verb. Coming is the main verb. Coming is the main verb. And what is here? It is telling you the
adverb.
Adverb.
Okay. Where the child is coming? The child is coming here. So what is here?
Here is adverb.
Adverb. Understood now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Any problem?
No, sir.
You're not? Now.
Yes, sir.
Let us write one more sentence. He is going for a movie today. Now, tell me, where is the verb first?
Sir, going. Going, yes, sir.
Good, good. And what is he?
Sir, he is. Sir, helping verb. Helping verb.
He
is going for a movie.
Again, you're forgetting. What is he?
Sir, adverb.
Adverb?
No, sir.
Sir, helping verb.
Helping verb.
Sir, helping verb.
He's helping verb.
Sir, pronoun.
Pronoun, yes. Nobody is concentrating in the class, I think. He is the pronoun. And what this is?
Sir, auxiliary verb.
Sir, is helping verb.
Very good. Helping verb or auxiliary verb, right?
Yes, sir.
So
yes, sir.
It's called as helping verb and it is also called as auxiliary verb. This is your helping verb. Now, what is today? What is today?
Sir, adverb.
Yes. It is adverb.
Adverb.
Understood?
Yes, yes sir. Yes.
Any problem?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Now. Okay, so yes. Today we'll be doing only these kinds of, these 8 parts of speech, okay? So first, let us revise one thing. Revise the thing in detail. Okay, children, what we have studied, first let us revise in detail. Let me give some sentences and that will be doing, okay? Okay?
Okay,
yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Let me give you one question. Okay, so it is, are you ready for the worksheet? Ready for the worksheet?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Your voice is not clear. Sir.
Are you ready for the worksheet?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Let me find the worksheet. Okay. Now. See, if you don't understand, tell me, children, okay? If you don't understand, tell me. You will be doing it again. But the thing is, the main thing is you have to underline.
Sir, adverb.
Yes, sir, adverb.
Adverb.
Sir, adverb.
Yes, sir, adverb.
Okay. First, let us do adverb. What I have told you, what are adverbs? Adverbs are the words that modifies a verb or an adjective. What is adverb? It modifies or describes a or adjective. Or
sir, a pronoun.
Or?
Pronoun.
Anything it can be, okay? Understood?
Yes.
Yes. Now, if I am want to tell you that how he is doing any work, it tells you how the work is done. It tells you where the work is done. It tells you in what
sir, manner why?
The work is
done. Sir, why?
It tells not why, okay? It tells you how the work is done, it tells you where the work is done, it tells you in what manner the work is done. Understood? So these are called as adverbs. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Is it clear, children? Now see. Yes, sir. Let me give you one example here. The example is, I am going tomorrow.
Tomorrow is adverb.
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow is
adverb.
Going is verb.
Yes.
Verb. Sir, going is verb and yes, sir. Is noun.
Noun.
And tomorrow is adverb.
That is I.
Sir, I is pronoun. Sir.
Pronoun.
Yes, sir.
Now, what is am?
Sir, auxiliary verb.
Yes, sir.
Right?
Yes, sir.
Auxiliary verb or helping verb. Now, what is going?
Sir, verb.
Sir, verb.
Verb.
Now, what is school?
Sir, noun.
Noun.
School is a? Noun.
Noun. Noun.
Tomorrow?
Sir, adverb.
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 Understood?
Yes, sir.
Any problem? Adverb.
No, sir.
No, sir.
Yes, sir.
So it tells you that what it tells where the work is done, how the work is done, and when the work is done, and in what manner the work is done. Yes, sir.
Yeah. Any yes, sir. No, sir.
Now, one more example. Example, okay?
Yes, sir.
The people are walking carefully. Where is the adverb?
Sir, carefully.
Sir, carefully is adverb.
Sir, carefully. Walking, walking.
Sir, carefully.
Sir, carefully.
How the children are walking? So the children are walking carefully. Carefully will be adverb. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Oh, understood now?
Yes, yes, sir.
Okay. So that time is also getting over. So we'll do the worksheet and everything tomorrow. Okay. Tomorrow
okay, okay, sir.
Happen class of language, and tomorrow we'll try to finish the chapter. Okay.
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 Yes, sir.
Your homework is revise chapter 3 and come for tomorrow's class. Okay.
Okay, sir. Yes, sir.